Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today I'm here with my second impression video. And I am doing like a new video on all my first impressions. I don't know if I explained this better in the first one, but I will leave the first part up here. But I am going through my playlist with all my first impressions, and I have start from the first impression I did, and then I'm going down. So today it is time for another Colourpop palette, and it is the Mar palette. And I have the old packaging. Now I think it's like this color, the whole palette. And okay, I am not looking forward to do this at all. I was like, should I skip this palette? But then I was like, no, I'm going to do them all. So the palette looks like this, and first I was like, okay, maybe I shouldn't do some with the blues, but I'm going to do that. So I will leave my first impression of this palette up here. So I will just do a makeup look that I want with this, talk a little bit about my feelings about this palette now, and just babble about things that I normally do. So yeah, I think we just get started. Okay, so in these first impression, or no, these second impression videos, I'm just going to do whatever I feel like doing. So yeah, I will start with this shade, and one thing I hate about this, the names. I don't know, because they are only in the back, and I don't know which one is which. So I will start with this one and take it in my crease. I think I used this in my crease in the first look as well. Shit, the same. So I will take this in my crease, and I don't know if this one and the Soul palette was like the first 9-pan palettes like this. These are not monochromatic, but I think these were Colourpop's first palette in this size. I'm not sure at all. And I always watch my video, the old first impression, when I'm doing, before I start to film these, to see like what I did for kind of look and everything. And I don't like to watch myself. And now both of these that I have done, they were from September 2018, so like 1.5 years ago, and my makeup style has changed, and what I like have changed as well. I was like, this is so much colorful. I usually don't use these colorful palettes. And look at me now, I think this is a neutral palette. Something like this, and then I go in with this dark brown and take it like out here and also a little bit up in my crease. I try to have it a little bit up in my crease at least. And I actually, in my first impression, I did a halo eye in that. And I just feel I don't like this palette. I don't know why. But sometimes it feels like the palettes that I bought in the beginning of my makeup journey, makeup life, I don't like that much now. Maybe that is a completely normal thing to feel. I don't know. And I think on my lid that I will take this one. Did I poke it? This one and this one. Yes. this that I'm going to use now, the one down in the corner, it looked so nice when I swatched it. And it looks so nice on the lid as well. And it's really easy to work with. Okay. I don't want to cover up all of the dark brown. Out here, so I'm going to try to have a little bit more brown. I don't know if these palettes are any popular from Colourpop. It doesn't feel like that. I know that they sold out like pretty fast. I at least think when they first came, but now it doesn't feel like like them as much. But what do I know, because I only like watch people on YouTube that like really colorful makeup, and this is maybe not the colorful makeup lover's dream. So yeah, and then I'm going to take this shade in the middle and have on the rest of my lid. And this looks like it has hard pan, but it picks up good on the brush and it swatched good, so yeah. Okay. Maybe this wasn't the best idea. Yeah. Do you know what? What's done is done. Okay. Do you know sometimes when you're like doing your makeup with a palette that you don't like that much and you feel like a little bit annoyed, even though the palette works good, you're just a little bit annoyed? And I am, and it feels like it's noticeable. I just want to be done with this. I think we just have to live with these lids. I'm not thrilled. I'm thinking about maybe taking this one in my inner corner, but it's not that. I don't really know. I will at least take away the fallouts, fix my base, and then I come back and we will see what I will do to the under eyes. And yeah, we will see. Time for under eyes, and I think I just want to go in with this one and have it on my whole lower lash. Actually, we'll see. So I tap it off. I think I want to go in with the dark brown, just a little bit out here to connect these. If it will stick. So, and then I swatched this before. It wasn't that light that I would hope it would be, but I think I'll take my pinky and in my inner corner, and it was not a good shade. Okay, so I will put on mascara, a lippy, and something in my waterline and see what I feel about the look then. Right now, I am not. I feel a little bit like that. So, mascara, waterline, and a lippy. So, this is the finished look. For my lips, I used Spice from Anastasia Beverly Hills. And for my waterline, I used Suglu from Colourpop. I don't really know. I think I should have taken, like, this color or this color instead of the blue. But it felt like I wanted to get some blue in this look because, yeah, I don't know. So, what do I think about this palette? I think it's good. The colors are good. It's normal Colourpop colors. Colourpop colors. Colourpop shadows. But I don't think this palette is for me. It's like the same with the Yes Please palette. I think if I would not use so much colorful makeup, maybe this would have been good, because you can do a natural look so easy, and then just the pop of blue and greens if you want to, but it's not my style anymore. And I have actually thinking about decluttering this palette, because it feels like this shade, it's a really, really good shade, but I think I have it in other palettes or something that is really, really similar, because it's nothing special with it. And like this dark brown, it's such a good dark brown, but I have other good dark browns. So, yeah, not a palette for me. It's a good palette, but nothing for me. And one thing that annoys me with this, I cleaned this before I started. Okay, I don't think you can see it, but it's a lot of blue. It's very dirty around right now. It's a lot of blue dust, and also dust from like this one. So yeah, it's a good palette, nothing for me. Thinking about decluttering, don't know if I will do it, but it's a good palette, but yeah. And that was my second impression of the Colourpop Mar palette. I hope you liked this series. It feels like now I have done it with this palette. Now I can go over to the next, because I didn't want to use this palette again, and that is never a good sign. I think the next palette I have is from Blush Tribe, and Blush Tribe isn't available anymore, or they are closing it down. So I am thinking about maybe try to dupe some of the colors in that one, my first attempt to dupe things. Yeah, we will see. But yeah, I really hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!